Hola, I'm Dora. I don't know why it's how I decided to start this. This will probably be the last Kingdom Hearts. I think next week I'll be doing Bloodstained, unless my unless I decide I want to do something else, because I do that, because I am a chaotic creature. But I do kind of want to do Bloodstained. I know there was DLC that came out recently. At least I think it's supposed to come out today? I thought it was supposed to come out today. Dude, it came out a couple days ago. Or is it standalone? Hold on, now I'm actually curious. Oh, they just didn't put it in the thing like they should have. Yeah, she's out now. But yeah, it's cool that she's Dominique's gonna be playable. Well, like I said, we'll see how I'm feeling. I might decide to change my mind and play something else, because I do that. I'll be calling the guys in just about 2 minutes. I am debating going back to doing solo streams again soon. I'm not sure, which I have to talk with them about, considering I've been roping them into this stuff for a while now. I'm not really sure. I might try to do an extra stream this week. Again, I'm not 100% sure. It depends on how I'm feeling and such like that. I want to stream more, but usually, like, with work and stuff, I'm usually just kind of exhausted and don't really feel like doing much of talking and just want to quietly sit there and vibe and either vibe with some friends in a call or what have you, or play a game quietly to myself. Like I've been doing with Neo 2 lately, which is a really fun game still. And I learned some like weird tech with the game that I really like that I want to experiment with later today on my own. But I don't know. Just a lot of little things on my mind, a lot of personal stuff that I don't want to unload because I don't talk about personal stuff Because that, nah, gross, disgusting, ew, get it out of here. So yeah, let me, real quick, I just need to check one thing. Okay, I am going to now take out the lovely, beautiful image, and I'm going to turn off the music, and I'm going to give them a call and start up the Kingdom Hearts video game. Where is the button? There's the button. Hello.
Hello.
It's time to maybe beat this game today.
That's ambitious.
It is ambitious after what happened last time.
Yeah.
If I recall, I think I'm already still at the Colosseum to do the Hades Cup. Because I know when we finished, walking out the door is basically then going into the series of Ansem fights.
Yeah.
And then it would just be the ending cutscene, so that would basically be like a half hour tops.
That would be my estimate, but you know, obviously...
Because I could also fuck up.
Yeah. Or I might just be misremembering how long the fight takes.
Yeah. I could also be misremembering it. Wouldn't be the first time. Won't be the last either.
But it will be the first.
The final.
Yeah.
I think it's funny that we're doing this today on the day that it finally launched onto Steam.
No, it's not funny, Dan. It's planned.
Oh yeah. It's all planned.
All fishing for that algorithm.
Ah yes, the algae rhythm.
It's not at all just complete random bullshit, which is how we operate at everything we do.
I mean, even like before I called you, when I was doing my little like post, my pre ramble, I was like, "Yeah, next week will probably be Bloodstained unless I change my mind."
Which you all want to do.
Yeah, I even said that. Like, I might just do it. I might just change my mind because I just fucking do that sometimes. Like, we'll get to the point, and I'll be like, "Ah, I don't want to do that anymore. I want to do Splork Blork." Which isn't an actual game, to my knowledge.
You just dropping your copy of Bloodstained. Oh, I don't want to play with you anymore.
I'm tired of you. And now we're in the Hades Cup.
Oh, see you in an hour.
I was trying to remember how to do lock-on, because I was trying to do the lock-on button, because I've been playing a lot of Neo. I was trying to like lock-on like it was Neo, which is a better lock-on system.
Yeah, but it also came out like 20 years afterwards, so...
Yeah, but a lot of games around this time also had better lock-on systems. A lot of games that are now... Well, listen, we can excuse this game, but we can't excuse Kingdom Hearts 3. Hell, I don't even think we can really excuse 2.
I think we can on 2, because 2 is built on the same engine and skeleton as 1.
True.
So, it's one of those things of...
We can fault 3, though.
Yeah, definitely. I'm sorry, when have I ever not faulted 3?
But yeah, but mainly just playing Neo too and learning some of the weird tech in that game. I also learned some of the yokai that are like optional fights, you can not fight them just by doing weird shit. And I think that's really cool. Like the Tanukis, what you can do is, if you know they're in one of the chests, you can whistle, have them pop out, imitate their gesture, and then they get happy and just give you the stuff and leave.
Nice of them. Other than that, it's actually been, I guess, pretty big, because there's been quite a lot of reveals. Not a whole lot I cared about, but...
In terms of stuff I care about, I got to see more of Sparking Zero, and yeah, the game still looks great! I'm excited for that game.
There's like, weirdly, that random Power Rangers game actually kind of caught my eye. So I'm like, that looks like Shredder's Revenge, and I really like that game.
Power Ranger game?
Yeah, there's a Power Ranger like 2D beat-em-up coming out.
Are you talking about the fan game?
It's not a fan game, it's a real game.
Oh, there's a fan game I've been following. No, there's a real one.
Yeah, I'll link you the trailer after we're done.
Yeah, okay.
Because it is basically looking like what if Shredder's beat Shredder's Revenge, but with Power Rangers.
I mean, I'm down for that.
Yeah, I really like Shredder's Revenge.
Yeah, it's one of the it's a really fucking good beat 'em up. It's just really good. Oh, I'm fighting the feet.
Also, there was like gameplay reveals for Metal Gear Solid Delta, which, you know, show off just fine.
Yeah. It sure looks like it looks like modern graphics Metal Gear.
It is nice that Hater's back, though.
More respect than Kojima gave him.
Yeah. Well, I guess it's their way of trying to make sure it's, you know, the game is legitimized in that sense.
I do hope that, I wonder how many of the voices, obviously they're still alive, they're going to be able to get back.
That is a good question. I guess we'll have to see.
Like, will Boss be voiced by Pearl from SpongeBob still?
I'm going to guess no.
I hope she is.
Also, the trailer Boss looked weirdly young.
I didn't really notice her looking young. I did notice that, like, her hair was a little longer. Not, like, long, but, like, it was a little longer.
But, I mean, I'm pretty sure most of the people who voiced them are... I don't think there's any huge names out of them, so most of them should be available.
Yeah.
Neil Ross is inexplicably still around. And he was Vulcan.
We need to hear FEAR exactly like that again.
Certainly should be able to get Josh Keaton back for Ocelot.
Yeah.
Wow!
Pretty good. But, I'm trying to think what else was... the new Doom, saying I have to wait for that when that comes out.
Well, yeah, it looks fine.
But also, on the other hand, Microsoft, so...
Yeah, it looks fine, but it's Microsoft. It's Microsoft now, so I trust it about as far as I can throw it.
So I'm expecting there to be, like, microtransactions up the wazoo, and then also, once it doesn't sell a bajillion copies...
and then they kill the studio.
It will be closed down. You know, we all know how this song and dance goes. We've seen it before.
Unfortunately.
What else? Yeah, as I said, weirdly, that Power Rangers game was like the first one, like, the second one I was like, huh,
yeah,
neat.
That was like the one I didn't know about because I didn't watch any of it live and no one was talking about it. So that's why I was like, wait, you know about that fucking that fan project that they've been working on? So I was like, that's cool, you know about a weird fan thing. But no, apparently a legit thing, huh?
Yeah, inexplicably legit. But yeah.
I mean, Power Rangers games were, the Power Ranger beat-em-ups were all pretty fun.
I was gonna say the beat-em-ups, because I thought you were gonna say it, and I was gonna immediately hit you with the one movie fighting game where it's just garbage.
Yeah, no, I said that, and I remembered the fighting games. I was like, wait, hold on! Those exist! The beat-em-ups! I just knocked out Yuffie.
It'll be the closest we get to having a good tokusatsu game for a while.
Yeah.
I'll keep an eye on that. Hopefully it comes out. I think it's coming out in October, so not too long to wait.
Hell, if it's half the quality of, like, Shredder's Revenge or Streets of Rage 4, I'd be happy. Not even, like, the full quality, just half, I'd be happy.
Yeah, fucking Shredder's Revenge is, like, maybe one of the most underrated games of, like, the last sort of last year.
That game plays as good as people think the original ones played. Not that they were bad games, but they definitely are not the strongest beat-em-ups around. Or at least usually the one people tout, which is Turtles in Time. Hyperstone's Heist was way better, but people get mad when I say that. They usually get even madder when I say a lot of the mechanics that Shredder's Revenge uses are takes from that game and, you know, improvements on them. And they usually just like, no, it's not. You just got to slam, you throw them into the screen. That's nice, buddy. Also, the throw actually fucking works in that game, which it never, consistently worked in the old games.
But also, it's got Usagi Yojimbo.
Now it does, like, yeah.
What else does need to be said?
As Usagi Yojimbo, Karai, Casey Jones.
Yeah, they're all fine, but, you know, Usagi Yojimbo.
Like,
I thought that might actually be the longest sort of running Western comic that's, like, under one guy.
Probably, yeah.
It's still going.
Because, like, Hellboy was one guy, but he finished. Like, that's done. Hellboy's done. It's been done for years. I still like the use of the monkey with the gun as a meme reaction. It's really good. He's got a gun!
Yeah. But I mean, even if he did, like, even if it was, you know, Hellboy was still going, Hellboy started in what, like, the 90s?
I think? I'm not really sure.
It's like he's been going on since the fucking 80s.
Yeah. You know, it's honestly really impressive that it's still going.
You know, I appreciate that, I think his name's Sakai, the author, that he also is, like, basically the reason sometimes things just take forever is because he has to meticulously research his, to make sure he's got everything right for his, because he wants to be as historically accurate, but also there are there's, you know, animal people. Random dinosaurs?
I mean, I get it. Because he wants to be faithful, but he also wants to do his fantasy thing, because he wants to make it feel more legit. I get it.
Also, everybody likes dinosaurs.
If they don't, I don't trust them.
I don't think there's ever been a single person who doesn't like dinosaurs.
It's probably so. I mean, I saw people be like, oh, well, dragons are lame. I don't like dragons. I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Dragons are cool, unless they're Skyrim dragons, and they're lame.
Can at least understand that, if only because it's, like, really contrarian, because, yeah, if there's a fantasy thing, a dragon's going to show up in some capacity. And if it's not a fantasy thing, chances are there'll be some dragon or dragon-related or dragon-adjacent thing. And I was like, yeah, I can kind of get that, you know, but that's on them. What I think is anybody who can look at any dinosaur and go, that's not cool, it's like, you're just not a person.
You're fictional.
Yeah. You don't exist.
Or somehow you're that Sam guy you guys talk about all the time.
Even Sam likes dinosaurs, he just doesn't watch Jurassic Park.
Oh.
Oh my god. Fucking, so he's talked about, a mutual friend of ours who I talked to, right? I was telling him about the whole, oh yeah, the guy who's playing Kazuma Kiryu in the upcoming Yakuza show is Kamen Rider Drive, because I've been telling everyone that.
Yeah, I actually was telling some friends about that the other day too. Oh god, Behemoth!
He's back.
Oh, I will never know peace.
So I told him that, and he's like, oh yeah, Sam, me and Sam were having discussions about Yakuza. He's never played, like, this one friend's never played, but, you know, he and Sam, like, are pretty good friends, / used to live together, so, you know, all made sense. I'm like, yeah, okay. So I go do the decent thing, I go to speak, go message Sam, I'm like, hey, the upcoming Yakuza show, this is the guy who's playing Kiryu, and here's what he was in before. And he's like, oh, that's neat. What I knew for... I like Kiryu from what I saw of Infinite Wealth. I'm like, wait, you haven't played any other game in the series? Fuck's sake. The one time I finally found something that he's definitely actually played, and he hasn't actually played it.
Actually, that reminds me. I haven't played it in a while, and I ended up putting it down. I think I'm probably gonna lower the difficulty. I actually, over time, the combat system in, Like a Dragon, I kinda don't like it. I've a couple of problems with it. One is, the parry window seems weird. The other, and I think more importantly, is that a lot of times, the timing is fucked up because of where enemy positions are. So, like, because enemies will actively just move around while you're idling. And, like, there's not really a good way to strategize it, but also, like, it'll be their turn, and then they'll just immediately hit you before the camera even gets to you. And just, like, little, like, issues like that kind of made me go, yeah, I like what the story's going, I like the characters, but god, the combat system's annoying the fuck out of me. So I ended up putting it down. I'll probably pick it back up, but I'll lower the difficulty just so I can kind of breeze through the combat.
Yeah, fair.
Because I just don't like it. Literally there for the story! But, it also made, like, strategizing, like, moves that attack multiple enemies, like, nearly impossible. Not impossible, just, you know, more random. And as someone who likes, like, strategy games and stuff, I'm like, I don't like this. Can't even strategize like it's an action game, so it's just, like, weird and bizarre, and it's just, like, you... I'm gonna assume that the games after, like, ironed out, like, more of the issues.
I think so. Bearing in mind, like, after seven, there's only really been like infinite wealth.
Well, yeah, there's infinite wealth and the Kiryu,
the man who sold his name.
Yeah,
or whatever. Which
actually, yeah, that one probably uses the same system because it was originally going to be a DLC thing.
Yeah, and the other thing is they also have done a judgment, but judgment plays different from Yakuza now.
I still need to play Judgment.
I need to play the second one. I own it, but I just still haven't got around to getting to it yet.
Like, I'm pretty sure I would like Judgment, I just haven't played it yet.
Yeah, it's basically Yakuza with some added detective minigames. I mean, they're not great minigames, but, you know, more excuse to play Yakuza.
Yeah. It's just, I just haven't played it as well. It's, like, no, like, big reason. Just sometimes it's just like that, where I'm just like, oh, I haven't played this, or like came out at a time where I was playing other things. And not to mention the fact that I even have a fucking backlog the size of a small planet. Mm. Hell, like Neo 2 was in my backlog, and I just, for whatever reason, my brain worms were like, let's play Neo 2.
Beyond that, yeah, just kind of waiting for Daybreak to come out in a couple weeks. Looking forward to that. And then also just, you know, election stuff over here. That is actually quite funny, but... No, actually, no, I'm going to talk about it, because it's been possibly the funniest, like, election...
At least we're doing it before Sabo gets here, and Sabo says something that like, makes us go...
Why? Doesn't know about this election.
I'm just making fun of him whenever politics conversations come up.
I can understand. One of his relatives worked.
Oh, yeah, for, yeah. No, I get it. At the same time, I'm like, I don't want to be here anymore.
Yeah. So... Our illustrious Prime Minister, who's unelected, but, you know, you never let that stop him, decided on a wet... on a wet May, it was torrential rain, and he decided that he was going to make an announcement outside Downing Street. So he goes out into the outside where all the reporters are, and they've all got fucking umbrellas, because why wouldn't you have an umbrella when you're going out to standing out in the middle of the street in London in the pouring rain? So anyway, he stands in the rain.
Typical day in London, as far as I'm aware.
Yeah, but getting absolutely soaked, and then he's like, okay, we're going to have an election, and like, a month. And bearing in mind, when he called this election, him and his party were 20 points behind their opponent in the polls. So yeah, it wasn't looking great to start with, and everybody else was like, why the fuck have you done this? But inexplicably, that was the high point of the campaign.
Oh, I'm fucking... you got me on the hook now!
I'm trying to think of which stupid bullshit thing to talk about. Okay, so first things first, he decides to announce he's going to reintroduce... he's not calling it conscription, but it's conscription, but national service. Which he decided that means that 18-year-olds will be forced to either take a placement in the army, or do, as far as I'm aware, unpaid community service... every weekend for at least a year. And you know, fuck you if you have a job or education or anything like that. You'll have to do this. And if you don't do it, you will have to pay a fine, because they basically were rolled out arresting, like putting 18-year-olds in prison for dodging service. So you know that's gone over well. And that might have been bad enough, but then, so you know how there was the whole D-Day celebration thing going on?
Yeah.
I don't know if you noticed, it was kind of a big deal, everyone was talking about it.
I mean, hell, it's talked about a lot over here, too.
Well, yeah, because basically all the Western world leaders were there, you know. You'd be insane if you were to, I don't know, leave early or something. That would be crazy. That would be so insulting to veterans and people with nationalistic pride, you know, so people who you might actually want to get on your side. So anyway, he left the services early, didn't attend the massive international event, which was, you know, all of the world leaders, all the world leaders are there, and then we just have our foreign secretary just standing there looking like an idiot, which is, you know, pretty average for him, I'll be honest. Being former Prime Minister David Cameron, aka Lord Pigfucker. But that's a whole other story.
I still love that fucking insult, Lord Pigfucker!
So yeah, he decides he's going to come back early, piss off everyone, and then you might think, okay, well maybe he had to come back for incredibly serious reasons, you know? He's Prime Minister of a major nation, surely there was like something going on that demanded his attention. No, he had to come back to do an interview.
Oh, you know, that seems really important.
Yeah, to do an interview to basically say, oh, that's another thing, because in a publicised debate against his primary opponent, he told what is is pretty obviously a lie, and everyone has said it's a lie. He had to come back and do an interview where he said, actually, I know everyone says it's a lie, and it's a lie, but it wasn't a lie, actually, thanks. So yeah, that was great, so he pissed off a lot of people, and he's had to apologise, which... You know, it's always a good sign when they apologize. And, yeah, just now they're even further down in the polls, and it's now not looking like a... Oh, that's another thing. They had a big debate amongst all of, like, the major party, not quite leaders, but main figures leading, like, second in commands of the parties. And, like, you know, Labour and Conservatives did their battle, and every other party said, well, yeah, obviously Labour's gonna fucking win. Like, that's not up for debate. The only debate is who's going to come second. So now they've gone from being a party that's late, that wasn't government, to now there's genuine talk of they might not exist in a month.
You know, I will say they did a great job of, you know, if they wanted, if their goal was to just, you know, get out of office, never have to work again. I think they chose all the right options.
Oh, and then I guess because Sinek just absolutely loves being the worst fucking stupid.
It reminds me of when, during the, when I was a teenager, obviously, when, Bush was against,
Gore?
No, not Gore. Oh, what's his fucking name? The guy who was after Gore.
Nobody cares about him, he's not even third place.
He, when he was running... he, like, one of the things he ran on was bringing back the fucking, draft.
Yeah, because people always say shit like this because they think, oh yeah, it'll definitely improve young people, and it's like, you know, statistics show that it actually doesn't. It doesn't really help with kids, it doesn't really help with, you know, teenagers, and doesn't really actually improve your military.
Nah. But, that was one of the things he ran off of, and I remember literally as a teenager being like, did he just want to lose the election? Was that his whole goal?
Yeah. Man, think of how many 18-year-olds there are in the country. Good thing I don't want any of them to vote for me. And then, like, the most recent stupid thing that happened, he had an interview. I forget if it was the interview he fucked off of D-Day for.
John Kerry, that was his name. John Kerry, I just remembered.
Or if it was a completely separate interview. But anyway, Sunak had another interview where, oh, we'll point out, between him and his wife, they have a collected wealth of $451 million. So, he's literally richer than the king.
Jesus Christ.
In terms of, like, complete wealth, because if you liquidated the crown assets, the king would be wealthier, but... You know, anyway, so he's literally richer than the king, and...
Either way, it's an insane amount of money.
And he was pressed on the whole... It was pressed on, you know, him. On his, because he said that, you know, when he was growing up, he knew what it was like to do without. And he was pressed on this question, you know. Well, what did you do without? Bearing in mind, his parents weren't super rich, but one was a doctor, and the other one ran a pharmacy. So they were pretty wealthy.
Listen, he wasn't running a pharmacy in America.
Oh, yeah. But, no, pharmacies get paid quite a lot here. But anyway, the main thing is that he was pressed and pressed and pressed, and eventually he settled on, well, I really wanted to have Sky TV. He basically said that he did without cable, and that means he understands what it's like to struggle to do without.
What?
Yeah. Yeah.
What?
He doesn't have... He didn't have cable when he was growing up.
I couldn't watch the Animaniacs!
That means he knows what it's like to suffer.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Nope.
How in the fuck is that the... I'm actually kind of... I'm both amused and angry.
What do I say? It's like... genuinely maybe the funniest election of all time.
Oh my god!
Only because one side just clear. I mean, it's been a legitimate question of... Has he just actually given up? Is he just intentionally sabotaging?
Right? It feels like that!
Because it does feel like he must be at this point.
That was literally a thing that people wondered about, and I still even wonder about, like, with John Kerry, with, like, a lot of the weird shit he would go on. They're like, no one wants this, right or left. What are you fucking on about?
Oh, Rishi.
Like, it's not even, like, one of those things where, like, say, like, someone on the left or the right might take a left or a right value to try and, like, coax people, like, in the middle. It's not even one of those things. It was just like, nobody wants to bring back the draft. What are you fucking doing, man? Nobody wants that. I do, usually when people say that too, it's usually people that would not never be able, that would never have to deal with the consequences of being drafted.
Yeah.
Crazy that, isn't it?
It's crazy to me because, as I said, I can't help but imagine, like, do you just not want, like, 18-year-olds to vote for you? Is that, like, is that the thing?
Right?
Because they ain't gonna vote for you if you pull shit like
oh,
this.
Oh, hi, Cerberus. So,
he's also back. Because why would an 18-year-old vote? Because even if it's not going to affect them immediately, they're still going to be like, hey, that might affect, you know, siblings, or I don't know about you, if I fucking was drafted.
I'm the youngest, so, like, the way the American draft system works is that the youngest is disqualified. Or, like, the youngest, like, it could only be men, and it would only, in the youngest, if there was multiple siblings, the youngest couldn't be drafted. So, like, I wouldn't have been affected, but even, like, in, obviously I was too young to vote, but I was like, why would I vote for that if I was? So, like, pretend he was there when I was able to vote, I wouldn't have voted for him.
Just an insane, idea. That I and nobody else could really figure out why he would announce it, because, yeah, it's just another group of people. And then, as I said, if it wasn't for the fact that he then he then did this whole D-Day thing, which pissed off all, you know, the nationalist people, you know, the people who they typically want to vote for them. It's like, okay.
You know, there are easier ways to shoot yourself in the foot, right? Like, actually shooting yourself in the foot.
Why don't you even bother announcing you're running, going for all this bullshit if you're not?
Just jump out. Stop running.
It's probably the funniest, like, legitimate election, because obviously there's, like, funny elections where it's like, but there's funny elections from the outside where you look and think, like, ah, ha, ha, Argentina's got this guy who's chainsawing and think, oh god, he's actually been elected, or ha, ha, America's got this stupid
arm. I just lost the Hades Cup. I'm probably just gonna go to the finale, I'm not gonna, like, brute force it, I just wanna do a run. Yeah. And I got some stuff for Donald and Goofy, so it's fine. I like the cup, but I got other stuff I gotta do today too after stream, so I don't wanna, like, do, like, an extended one today or anything like that.
That's fair.
Oh, the shield that I picked up from Goofy is actually not as good as what he's already got, so it doesn't really matter. So let me save the game, and then I will head back over there. But yeah, I don't know, it's just funny is this like a bit? Are they doing this just because they don't want to win? Is that the thing? Is that what they're doing? Are they actively trying to lose? Like, it's just insane. Hmm.
Also, I guess, speaking of stuff, I did finally get around to watching Lupin the First.
Ooh, nice.
It is the best Indiana Jones movie we've had since the 80s.
I should watch that at some point.
You should, it's really good. I liked it.
I mean, I like Lupin the Third. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm more of a fan of, like, you know, like the season, like that kind of, like, feel of Lupin, where it's, like, kind of silly.
Yeah, this is fairly silly. It's the best Indiana Jones movie we've had in a while, but it does very much feel like that one Tintin movie meets Indiana Jones with the Lupin flair. So no, I enjoyed it.
Ah, they're giving you the, this is the, there is no turning back here thing. I do like it when games give you that heads up. We're like, hey, once you do this, there's no turning back.
Do all your side quest shit now, idiot.
It's the beach!
We're so back.
Oh, but, I do... But yeah, I'm trying to think of, like, what other... Like, a lot of the games that I'm, like, looking forward to are, like, weird indie stuff, like Frogun Encore. Barring, like, the... Obviously, the big one being, like, Sparking is, like, the big one that's, like, a big game. Because, the game looks really good, and I liked Tenkaichi, so...
Yeah.
And being able to clash with my fucking Dragon Ball action figures again is an exciting prospect to me.
Hmm. I'm just kind of curious as to see who they'll wind up including overall, because I've not looked at any leaked lists, if any actually exist.
I don't know if there are any. I haven't seen them if there are.
I'm mostly just sort of debating.
Some YouTubers were given like 30 minutes to play the game, so we've seen some footage of like raw gameplay, and it looks like Tenkaichi, but obviously much better looking because newer hardware and shit. The animations look really good.
They can finally delete future Gohan's arm.
It's true. One of the things that I saw that you can do now is you remember how before if you were doing team battles, you had to have in order to do a fusion option, you had to have the characters at the same power level. So they had to be like the same form. You don't need that anymore because one guy he had I think it was God Vegeta, not like Blue, and then Blue Goku, and he was able to do the Gogeta fusion after he like depowered into base form. Soon to be complete. Like because he tried it after he depowered. Not that he tried it before, so you don't need the same version of the characters in order for it to work anymore. It looks like.
A meaningless effort.
It looks good. I do like the whole like being able to create your own custom scenarios, and I'm curious if like you can also add dialogue, like you know text dialogue. To it in like a little cutscene, so I'm wondering how nutty you can get with it. Like if you can make like crazy boss fights. Hercule can't fly anymore, he has no jetpack, he just can't fly.
Can't even do like the running air shit he used to do, so shame.
At least what I saw, is I only saw like a snippet of someone playing him, but he had like crazy like ground dodges and shit. Because people were like, wait, how is Hercule gonna fly without his jetpack? The answer is he doesn't.
That's the beauty of it. You don't. Freedom.
This island is a prison.
But
surrounded by water.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to Sparking.
And like the environments are like incredibly destructible. The weather changes when you power up and the transform and shit. It looks really cool. It's a damn shame that because of Xbox Series S that the only split screen fights you can get are in the hyperbolic time chamber.
Riku. Oh, can it not handle?
It's the Series S or X or whichever one it is, the one that's like really weak, is really weak, and it's actually why a lot of games don't have features that they used to have, because Microsoft has a mandate where all the features that are in other games have to be in that game, have to be compatible with that system as well. So because of that, a lot of games will not have features that they could have otherwise. That's why like Halo Infinite didn't have split screen co-op.
Yeah. I assumed it's because the Halo dev team are fucking lazy these days.
No, it's actually people found it in the system. People hacked it back in. It was implemented, but Microsoft said no. The Series S has to be able to do it. Otherwise, you can't have that. It's their fucking weird mandate for their underpowered piece of shit system. Like, it's very stupid.
Yeah, sounds like Microsoft.
Stuff like that is also why, like, there's a couple of reasons why I migrated off of console to, like, PC, and that's stuff like and that. Stuff like that, like, honestly, the convenience thing just isn't there anymore. And, like, physical copies don't usually actually have the full game on them anymore. And I don't mean like, oh, you gotta download an update. I mean like, just the full game isn't there. Also, the Come Guardian's here. Come Guardian! Submit!
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 You see, he does spam submit quite a lot.
Submit! In his stando, come!
JoJo's reference? Maybe a reference to that one comic who had stands that I forget the name of.
Oh, the one with just like wholeheartedly ripped it off.
Yeah.
I don't remember what it was called, but I know what you're talking about.
Which, bafflingly, wasn't actually done from a place of malice.
Yeah, they just really liked it.
Well, it's not even that. They really liked it, but also it wasn't out in the West.
Yeah.
So, they did their version.
We'll do our version with Blackjack and Hookers because it's not here.
Because we ain't got our version. We ain't got a version we could actually, you know, enjoy. Which, you know, I
completely,
appreciate.
Honestly, completely fair. It's funny in retrospect now that we have it, but it, honestly, like, when you think of the time, it makes sense.
I mean, fan games and stuff have been doing that. Or, you know, like, game, or certain other games that are just basically like, hey, we wanted... Hey, we wanted to do this. We want more of this game, but they ain't making it, so we made our version of it.
I mean, that's what like a lot of the indie scene is.
Yeah.
Freedom Planet 2 and 1 and 2 are literally we wanted to make a similar to classic Sonic game, so we did.
Did you see the trailer for Sonic X Shadow?
I saw bits and pieces of it. I haven't watched the whole thing.
Have you seen what Shadow's new power is?
Ah, his edgelord form. We're back! Shadow is being an edgelord again!
He's given up on Latinas.
I've given up on Latinas, Sonic.
Back to the edge.
Ow. Oh god! I got grappled. That hurt.
Should have submitted.
Oh my god, he's just spamming that barrier now.
Yep.
Yep, yeah, I grapple again.
It do be like that.
It's like playing a game. It's like he's playing a game of keep away with me. Grappled again. Grappled again. Wait, I was like, I had like tons of health. How did I die? What? Huh? What?
What happened?
I just died! I was at practically full health and I just fucking died! What the fuck?
Let me go and have a look at Smike. Did you get past the dark side, or is that just first form?
This is first form. He kept like spamming the barrier earlier, so I wasn't getting. So at one point, I couldn't really hit him too much.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about the thing where the Come Guardian like blocks attacks. I'm talking about the fucking shield. He flies at you.
Yeah. Back in we go.
Come on. It, like, it's annoying because, again, it's like he just plays keep away with you. It's like trying to bat a fly.
Yeah, he do be like that.
Jesus. Oh, I did not do shit. I tried hitting him with a fireball. Ooh, I can tech that at him.
Oh, yeah.
Good to know. Well, at least I got him. I'm getting him close to yellow health.
That's good. I forget. Did we ever get high enough level to unlock Leaf Bracer and,
I had Leaf Bracer.
The, Once More, I think it's called.
I don't remember if I've Once More. I don't think.
Oh, we'll see. We'll see when you get to, like, either the Break in the Fire or the, If we do die again, we'll double check.
Oh, now it's Shield Spam.
You can't. I think Strike Ray is pretty good against him, or Ragnarok.
Ow. Ah, he's doing the fucking thing again! You're an annoying cunt, you know that? Grappled again. God damn it! I hate him. I'll hit load game and look.
Yeah, it should just drop you outside the thing, right?
Well, if I hit load game, yeah, if I hit continue, I wasn't sure, so I couldn't remember that moment. But now I think about it, like, yeah, it would drop me out of it, but whatever, it's fine. I can just skip those cutscenes.
Yeah.
Abilities. Once More, is that what you're saying?
I think it's called that.
I don't see it. Sonic Blade, Leaf Racer, Lucky Strike. Second Chance? Is that the one health thing?
It might be. Yes, it might be Second Chance. Is that equipped?
No, I don't really have the AP for it either. Because let's see, I can get Slap Shot out.
Have you got any AP ups in your items that you've ignored?
I don't. Let me look. I don't know. No. I think I used them all last time.
How much AP do you need?
I need 5, so I need to remove at least, is there Sonic Blade? What does that do? You know what? I can get rid of that.
Yeah, Sonic. You're probably.
Yep, now I got enough for it, so.
Alright, yeah, so that should help, because Second Chance comboed with, Leaf Bracer gives you, at least makes it so you can't die. Or you have a chance to heal, and while you're healing, you're immune. Also, do you have MP Rage?
MP Rage. Doesn't look like I have that ability.
Double check, see what if that's in this game slash what level.
I'm level 51 right now. I kind of wish I went with my gut this week, and just because I was like, yeah, maybe I should grind in the game before stream, and I was like, no, I shouldn't grind. I should have.
Face. Wait, why do you learn it? Why can you learn it twice? Oh, right, yeah. Apparently you should have it, because you learn it at 36 with the Dream Shield in 1.
I don't have it. I can go through it again, and I'll show you.
Hang on, let me pull up the stream then real quick.
Yeah, I just gotta skip through this dialogue. And save while I'm here, so that way I don't gotta look at that dialogue again.
Right, I am watching the stream.
See?
I'm just scrolling down. Ah, oh, weird. All right, well, what level did you say you were? 50?
51.
Yeah. All right, well, hopefully just the second chance would...
I mean, I got him low. The main reason he... I got him low on that one. The main reason he won on that one is because his AI went into just spam the shield cycle again. Because that's one thing that I kind of replaying this, I started to realize I don't like it, that sometimes the AI will just spam shit. And sometimes you just don't have an answer for it. Then don't get hit.
This world has been connected.
And sometimes you can't just not get hit. So it's that thing where I've kind of it's kind of a complaint I've started forming in this game. Not that I think it's bad, just annoying to where it feels like a lot of times like I was probably way over leveled by the time I got here in my actual playthrough as a kid.
To the heart-seeking.
So I probably just like beat sticked everything at a ridiculously high level.
Possible. So I think. So I guess now that we're here, I think. You remember those questions when we had to decide the stat distribute or like the way we accrue levels? I think it's 50 is the cutoff point for either high or low. So it takes ages. So you know, if you pick the one.
I think we did the middle of the road one.
No, yeah, we did middle of the road because that's just objectively the best one. Because playing it, because I mean, like I said at the time, the problem is if you are playing it for a playthrough, it's like either you're gonna have to spend for ages trying to grind up if you're taking the latter one to get to the point where the levels. It's like, it's probably better to do like on like a set on like a solo, just for fun, like do the have the levels like get the ones where it levels up faster in the late game, but you know, as I said, you don't want that to be on a like streamed playthrough.
Yeah, especially when it's like a more casual like playthrough where I'm not trying to do every little thing.
Oh yeah, that's another thing. Comic Storian died.
Who?
Comic Storian. He's a YouTuber. He was like a big YouTuber who did like comic stuff.
Yeah, I'm not really familiar with him.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm getting a lot better cycles this time.
Well, the main point is that he can't like with second chance. He can't surprise one shot you.
Like there.
Yeah. It drops you down to one. It gives you enough time to put up a quick cure. Which, thanks to Leaf Bracer, you are invincible while using cure.
I the Cum Guardian's pissing me the hell off. Like, what am I supposed to do when the Cum Guardian decides just to pop on and hurt me?
Spam dodge roll is all I can suggest.
Yeah, that doesn't even fucking work.
Oh, Sabo's here.
Hello, Sabo.
He's fighting Ansem. No, he gave up.
I only wanted to do one run because it was mainly to extend time, because I wasn't sure how long it could take.
I was gonna say, if you were getting smashed by that one room, I don't think you could have knocked out the Hades Cup in an hour.
No. But I was having trouble. He pointed me in the direction of an ability, so I wouldn't get fucking a slap by the Comm Guardian out of nowhere, because the Comm Guardian likes to do that.
Yeah, I didn't realize we didn't have second chance enabled, so... So, let's see how he goes. How are you, Sabo?
I did beat first form.
I'm ducking in and out of here. We're a little busy over here, so I don't know how long I'll be able to hang on, but...
That's fine.
I saw you were fighting Ansem, so I was like, oh, okay, I guess he won't be spending 2 hours fighting the Hades Cup before he gets over to that.
I did, like, a run. I got up to Cerberus, died on Cerberus. I was like, alright, I don't want to sit here for, like, multiple hours doing this if I can help it.
Filthy casual.
Yes.
Did you get your thing, by the way?
Or I did. Not... I didn't
oh,
have,
you got
I,
it.
I didn't have time to set it up yet because of all this stuff going on here, but yeah, I didn't know.
Hooray! It's not a picture, is it?
No, it's not a picture. I had the guy shake the box to put it through something. Because I told him a story.
Honestly, in a fucked up way, he probably didn't even blame you.
Wow. Yeah, I was like, if I open that box and there's a picture in it, I'm going to come back and I'm going to be very angry. So he shook the box and like, no, there's something there.
It's a bomb.
Rocks.
Well, hopefully by next week we can start talking about Rebirth.
Hooray!
Hey. Except for Dan, unless Dan doesn't care.
Dan doesn't care.
I don't care.
Healthy casual.
The only thing he cares about is maybe Gilgamesh, but by the time he gets to play, he'll get around to playing Rebirth.
I'll probably get Rebirth and Remake around the same time as each other.
He still hasn't played Remake yet.
Yeah, so by the time he gets around to them, he'll have forgotten everything we talk about anyway.
Unless I remember it, despite I won't.
That's sort of how it worked with Cold Steel.
I mean, sort of.
I'm pretty sure I explained the entire plot to you because I didn't think you'd ever want to touch it, and then you played it, and I was like, oh. And you're like, it's fine, I forgot most of what you said, except that... Crow is going to betray me, but I can tell that just by his name.
Yeah, because all crows are evil. But I mean, to be fair, like, with how much plot there is in Cold Steel, very hard to remember all of it. I'm pretty sure if I replayed the series now, which I would almost be tempted to do, but I don't think I'd get it done fast enough to get before Daybreak comes out. I'll be like, oh yeah!
You didn't finish the last one.
Because it's just so fillery, and it's just... But it'd be one of those things where maybe if I hadn't have played Zero and Azure...
I said it was just really bad timing on the US side, because it was designed to, like, for a nice coming back to Crossbell after 10 years to settle things on before it moves on, except... Alright. Except in the US, like, Zero and Azure literally came out. So it's like, we played this game.
Second form is down.
And then we're playing this game again. It's like, we were just here.
Now to fight Ansem again, but this time by myself.
Yeah, and this time he's got some bullshit. He's got some more bullshit.
Oh, boy.
No, he's already using the Guardian. Now he's got the dash.
Oh.
Remember the dash move?
Honestly, no. I played the first game and it's incredible.
When he starts dashing, just...
I see Dan's using Ragnarok, finally.
Yeah. He's also has got Strike Rate equipped, so... should be doable. Like, once you pass this, I think this is the hardest fight in terms of in this whole thing.
Yeah. Oh, God.
But I believe in you, buddy. I believe. I do. But,
I mean, I believe it's
at least suddenly in trouble with it. No, to be fair, that is a pretty lengthy fight scene. That is a pretty lengthy sequence.
I had never had trouble with that. Like, several times.
After I completed all of the stuff before and was at a much higher level.
It's fine. It's fine.
Oh, you're supposed to, that's the way you're supposed to play it.
It's fine. We're past it. We're doing the final boss. And as I said, I'm pretty sure this second fight with Ansem is the hardest one, just because A, you don't have Donald and Goofy being damaged sponges, and you don't have, and also he's got some new moves. But yeah, looking forward to Daybreak. I can't. Well, I mean, the only thing I really know about it is about Grendel, but. Oh, and Grimcat, but does that really count, knowing about those two?
No.
How soon in do you get Grendel out of curiosity? I know you don't actually get Grendel, like, it's not like Ogre Form. It's not like.
No,
Ogre Form.
It's like Ogre Form, where you only get it situationally in the first game and don't actually get to keep it in the second.
But I meant it's like you don't get to, like. It's more like Valamar, where it's key fights you can use it.
Yeah. Pretty early on, but like, okay. they have to spread it.
I got him, or?
And then I got the heal off, as I was saying.
It's not like Grimcast that you can just use whenever you want.
And I do know in the second one there is Red Grendel.
Yes.
Well, that's the main thing. That's the only things I really know about Daybreak. And also the returning characters. I wonder if we're saying farewell to Zemuria, where we'll be going then. Yeah, but where in space? Also, it feels weird that, I guess, that you can't leave the continent, but you can go into space.
Well, you're not supposed to be able to do either, but you don't have magic.
Ah, divergent magic.
Yeah, something divergence.
I'm really hoping it's not just going to be Somerville, that this is all a simulation. Feel like it is, but...
God, I hope they'll go to Star Ocean Road. That would be... I'm expecting the reveal as the planet and then see away from the universe for whatever reason.
I mean, there's that, but I'm a bit concerned with some of the...
If it's the Star Ocean thing, it's all a simulation.
We're all just bits in a computer. And I'm like, yes, we've all seen Gridman. We've all seen SSSS Gridman. I haven't seen the movie. It was okay. Yeah. I don't know, there's a whole lot of,
He's almost dead. He's in that cycle again where I gotta just dodge for a while.
Dodge.
Dodge, dodge, dip, dive, and dodge.
Submit.
You can dodge or submit, you can dodge, Thumb Guardian.
Oh, he's doing the fucking shield rush again. You know what? I can kill you with this. Fuck off, die. Kill him with Ragnarok. He was doing it again, I was like, wait, I'm invincible in Ragnarok. Die! Alright, now it's time for the ship.
Yeah, but the ship's just more gimmicky than serious fight.
Within it lies the heart of all worlds.
Kingdom Heart. The door! Oh yeah, Saber, did you wind up seeing Gundam Seed yet, or have you not seen it yet?
You'll not find
even
the smallest glimmer.
I was gonna say, I'm fairly confident if I say you've seen Gundam Seed the show.
Has he? I don't know.
What
a twist. I never actually watched it. I was just going off
you,
hearsay the whole time.
You were Sam all along!
Da-da-da-da.
It's a great character piece.
I told this story to Dan, but I'll tell you. So I was telling... I was telling Sam, because a mutual friend of ours had said, oh yeah, me and Sam always talked about Yakuza just the other day. I was telling him that, oh, Kazuma Kiryu is now Kamen Rider Drive. Or Kamen Rider Drive is now Kiryu, whichever way you want to say it. And I was like, oh, that's great. And he's like, oh yeah, I haven't played any of them. I'm like, why the fuck are you talking about stuff you've not played again? Fuck's sake! Play the game!
No! I refuse!
It's when he was fucking telling, you know, when I'm like, oh, he also likes Resident Evil, that's great. Yeah, I really like those light gun games. Uh-huh, and that's all I've played. That's all I need to play to understand the story. I'm like, what?!
Turn to darkness.
Ugh.
Welcome to darkness into your heal.
That's what Resident Evil is, right?
It is for him. It is for him. Oh. Yeah, I was telling Dan about that Power Rangers game I linked to the other week, or last week.
Yeah,
yeah, I gotta look at that trailer.
The new show they're working on Netflix is now being canceled.
Netflix canceling the show?
They are instead moving forward on other options with a new partner.
Oh. So.
Surprise,
not,
Ray.
They're not happening, gotcha.
Yeah. Well, I was like, imagine if the new partner is Toei. And they're just like having Toei directly help out now. In exchange for less license blocks on them.
Will make sense.
Now that Saban's not in control.
Yeah, but now it's Hasbro.
Yeah, but Saban was like attempting Harmony Gold levels of bullshit lawsuits.
Ah, yes.
Like anyone in any kind of colored armor, he apparently thought was riffing on Power Rangers, even though it's not.
Even though that's not how copyright works. Oh well, he's gone now.
He'll be dead soon. He's an old man.
You say this, and yet, oh fuck, why am I blanking on his name? Guy who owns Fox.
Rupert Murdoch?
Rupert Murdoch, that was it. Yeah, he's still alive, and he's been old for like ever. Just married his fifth wife.
Gotta get the new model.
Just another woman who's like, maybe this time he'll die.
Yeah, basically, I'm pretty sure that's how it is. He gets the new model and he's like, maybe this time he'll die and I'll get the money.
Unfortunately, no, he has a phylactery.
Yeah. He's not like Stan Lee who just survived the souls of his rivals. He eventually ran out of rivals.
That's how Hulk Hogan stays alive.
Dara's daughter killed him.
I like my version better. I thought Hulk Hogan survived by the hatred of Iron Sheik.
No, that's how Iron Sheik lived. He lived so long. Eventually, the hatred wasn't enough to sustain his body.
I guess Hulk Hogan isn't long for this world.
Most of them are dead.
I always fucking remember when there was like some radio show or that was doing an interview with Jack Kirby on his birthday, and Stan Lee called, and it just turned into an argument. It was Jack being like, "Yeah, why don't I own the things that I create?" And Stan Lee basically like, "Well, you weren't that good, Jack." Oh, on his birthday, yes.
Stan, he was so not that good that you kept taking it from him for years!
Yeah. But he does.
I found someone better to take from. Who is it? Who is Stan?
So I've not been following, and none of the people I usually talk to about this are even following. I'm pretty sure, like, Zeb Wells is now doing a thing where Peter Parker is Green Goblin. Yeah. I'm like, man, why hasn't someone like just got rid of him yet? They're being killed.
Because Marvel likes trash, and they only like it when you produce trash. And Zeb makes the most disgusting garbage outside of doing things that are like creepy, only just a little creepy.
Give it time. I wouldn't be surprised if he gets accused of something.
Nah, I don't think women get close to him.
I don't need to willingly get close to him to do something horrible, Dan.
I think he's too much of a bitch to get close himself.
So yeah, all of this to say, Spider-Man's still awful.
Surprise, phase. Don't mind me, I'm just wailing on Ansem.
Fighting in boat form now.
Okay, I don't remember if he's got multiple forms in boat or not, but if he does, I beat the first part of it.
Sort of, but also kind of not really. It's not exactly other forms, it's more like just progressing for it to actually be into the fight. And also you need to free Donald and Goofy when they get captured, because...
Yeah, I think I'm in the free Donald and Goofy part. Because I'm now, like, in a dark room fighting a bunch of little Heartless.
Yeah.
Considering it's blue, this is probably Donald.
Should hear him go, "Wah!" at some point.
Oh, I got an achievement! Heartless Hunter!
Neat.
I'm pretty sure it just means I killed a lot of enemies.
You'd assume so. But on the other hand,
I actually do not remember these parts of the fight. I realize I don't remember a lot of the boat form.
It's not super interesting, like.
Because, I mean, most of that fight I spent just wailing on him when I was low on ki, beating up the little mooks, mana, just beating up the mooks to get more mana so I could make sure I keep having heals to stay alive. Just kind of rinsing and repeating, ducking in and out here and there.
Hmm.
Alright, well, that room's cleared. Now it's time to fight the boat again.
Now you gotta rescue Goofy.
I gotta fight the little spores on the boat. Which is only kind of annoying, because sometimes when you hit stuff, you'll clang against the side and your keyblade will go backwards.
Keyblade!
But,
Yeah, it just kind of is.
As frustrating as the other form was, there was more to, like, react to. It's just me kind of just beating up on a wall for a bit, and the wall pushing me back occasionally. The Chernabog was harder than this so far. The Chernabog loved to spam shit where it was, like, difficult to get in on them. In fact, this form seems easier than the one where I was fighting Ansem before he went inside of his heartless body thing. Since, like, he could hit me pretty hard. And there was a lot more of these lasers popping out.
Yeah. Like I said, you've already kind of got past the hardest bit. Like, yeah, maybe some stupid bullshit might catch you off guard here, but realistically, that solo fight with Ansem is the final fight. Like, this is that moment, you know, in the Persona game final bosses where you've got past the actual fight and now it's just into the more or less the...
Oh, hey, Goofy!
The scripted event. Or not quite scripted, but you're not really going to lose this from this position.
It's a lot harder to lose it than...
I'm going to try switching to my crappy laptop.
Oh.
So I can not have to leave, so...
Well, I'm pretty sure we're nearly done, so...
Yeah.
We are nearly done, so... Alright.
It'll be the final cutscene soon. And, I already cleared Goofy. We got Goofy out. I don't have Donald yet. Let me kill myself real quick before the transition pops up. Oh, there was still one left. I'll be dead. So, like, Goofy's out now. And I don't have Donald yet. I thought it was going to be Donald, but then I realized he wasn't in the room. I realized, I was like, oh, I guess not, because he's not here. And then I come here, and it's like, oh, Goofy's out now.
Goofy, too.
Electric Boogaloo.
Extremely Goofy movie.
Honestly, you know what? That was a fuck. That name was perfect. Extremely Goofy movie, too.
Yeah.
Oh, now I just gotta fight the penis. I mean the head. I mean the penis. Oh. I mean the head. I mean the penis. I mean the head.
All my googling of Kingdom Hearts stuff has already got a new Kingdom Hearts video on my recommended that just says, "Do we need remakes of Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2?" No.
Not really.
No, because these games are on everything.
No. Yeah. Exactly. Literally, they're on Steam right now. Like, they don't really need it. They don't need a remake. Like, there's stuff that is rough around the edges, but like I've mentioned, but, like, they're good games. Honestly, the game would be, of course, smoother if I did do everything. I didn't.
And, of course, the other problem is there's lots of stuff that you wouldn't be able to get, because there's...
Like, Tarzan.
Flash in the pan. You ain't gonna get... Yeah, you can't bring back, like, the Tarzan world, which means that, okay, so you have to either cut out a world or build an entire new one. So then it's like, okay... I'm pretty sure a bunch of the actors you wouldn't be able to get back. You wouldn't be able to get Haley Joel Osment to undo fucking puberty.
You can't.
Crazy. This is the only game where Sora sounds like a kid.
Because it's the only game where he was a kid. The actor.
Well, yeah, and then of course puberty comes and he sounds like, well, how he sounds now. Which, you know, it's fine, like, it's a good... It actually works as a really good transition like, 1 and 2.
Oh, yeah,
and then
no.
It is jarring if you play Chain of Memories, which obviously got dubbed way later.
Yeah, and he sounds like, you know...
And in the space of, like, a day, Sora's voice has aged, like, 2 years.
It's like, Sora, your balls dropped!
Yes.
I have returned.
Look at that. Hey, doesn't sound too bad.
Ooh, that is not... That was not good.
Crying.
I almost died.
You're now being broadcasted live.
Coming to you live. Saturday Night Live.
Live to my living room. There's nobody here but me and my sister's dog.
Special guest Goku.
Your sister's dog, eh? What's the dog's name?
Ducky.
That's a terrible name.
It's named after the dinosaur from Land Before Time.
Oh.
Oh, that makes sense.
So it's named after a dinosaur, but it's also named after a duck. None of which are dogs.
So that's because one of like, the names they would call a dinosaur is a duck-billed, like a duck-billed dinosaur or something like that. That's not the official name, obviously, but I remember that was like something they would call it.
In the movie, the ducky is one of them.
She is. I was explaining that to Train.
She was also voiced by Judith Barcy before she was horrifically murdered.
Yeah, this is what I like about you, Saber. You always know how to raise the mood of the in any situation.
I know all the tragic stories.
Talk about anything.
She was in Land Before Time and All Dogs Go to Heaven, and then her father murdered her.
Thanks. Just what we needed, the murder of a child, thanks.
We really are in the world, we are really in the darkness now, aren't we? Don't forget about
silly Billy, Kingdom Hearts is light, you're right.
I mean, it's
dark,
light until
light,
then,
dark,
as soon as that's done, and the light kill, and the light defeats Anson, and then it's like, oh yeah, there's just a shit ton of Heartless in there, though.
It's true.
So I'm like, who was right?
Yes.
Everybody was wrong.
Except me, I was the most right.
And I assume that all those Heartless weren't supposed to be there. But, you know.
But then it's like, oh, that's the Realm of Darkness, so it's not actually Kingdom Hearts!
You know, Heartless aren't supposed to be going around destroying stuff and devouring worlds, that's all. It's Xehanort's fault.
You know, I wonder whose fault it's going
to be.
Who are the bad guys in Union?
Me.
Oh, I don't even know. Maybe it was retconned to be there.
because...
My only question, because I don't know anything about it. I only know, like, from the cutscenes of Union I watched. And even then, I'm, like, eyes glazed over at, like, 90% of it. Union is, like, fucking impenetrable.
Union is full Nomura. Full unfiltered Nomura. All it needs is, like, a zipper around the game picture.
Well, now it needs shaved heads. He really likes that hairstyle now.
Well, I'm gonna say, is that Nomura's new thing, shaved heads?
I'm making a joke about, Stranger of Paradise.
Oh. I mean, he looks strange. Final Fantasy character, so...
He looks like a Western video game character from, like, the, 2008.
Yeah, I know. Well, he's there to fight Chaos.
Oh, is that it? Did I just beat it?
Fight Chaos. Beat it.
Is there another form? So I slapped the jack-o'-lantern face in the middle.
Chaos stole my lunch money.
Okay, another form. He's pulling out his sword.
Oh yeah, this is the final fight.
I'm gonna look it up to see if we can tell who the enemies of the NPR are or whatever it's called. But yes, I ain't seeing it. Yeah, I don't know, man. All the Union stuff is, like, fucking impenetrable. So I just ignore it and hope it's not going to be relevant, apart from Mushu and the Master.
Don't worry, he'll make it direly important.
But you know what? Mushu and the Master aren't even really in Union Key anyway. They're just there in, like, cutscenes, so the Master can be like...
The next point is just to make Versus 13, except...
Yuzura instead.
Yeah, basically.
Damn,
Zora's kind of cool, I guess. Some of the robots in a planetarium. Wasn't afraid of anything.
Does he become the robots?
No, he just sticks some robots on him.
Shame.
He was almost there.
He can steal your revival items and use it himself to bring it back to the wild.
What a dick.
Yeah, he's like the hardest boss ever.
Damn, Zora.
Well, his only weakness is that you can pretty much hit him whenever. You don't need to wait for a gap in his defense. It'll shoot him nothing.
Just wail on him, gotcha.
Lingering Will, where it's like, unless you're hitting him when he's coming out of a combo, he'll take basically no damage.
Ah, yes, Lingering Will. One day I'll get around to fighting, I'll get around to doing the Remind / Azora stuff. Not this day, though. But hey. Now you have to fight him with his Darth Maul, with his like Darth Maul double-edged Soul Eater. Still are.
I was gonna say, they still are cool. I still think they're cool. I mean, mainly quiet because I'm managing like HP and all that shit while fighting him.
Yeah. On the home stretch.
Yeah. So I'm kind of like leaned in at this point. Ow.
Dark.
He's on green.
Oh, well, oh my.
Need a couple of these to the face, unfortunately, which is annoying.
You can do it. You can win. You feel great. You can do this.
Immediately knocked out.
That should be Piccolo's like taunt and sparking zero.
Life for great!
Oh yeah, this is done. This is done. He's dead. Got him.
It's over.
It turns out he couldn't do it after all.
No. I have another form. Again?
He's like that's cute, but I still have two more forms to go through.
I'll admit you're strong, but I have another form. What do you mean you have another form? I have another form.
I'm wearing weighted armor. Oh, Hellclan. Same as it always does. 100 kilo.
That sounded way more impressive back in fall.
Yeah, but then they start being able to, you know, bench planets. But you know what? Goku was defeated by a rock.
It's true. Also a gun.
It is futile.
He walked off the gun.
Cannot see
the rock seemed to cause him the most pain.
Ah!
Hello, what
fill
the fuck?
I hear you. You know what? Fill me with the power of darkness.
Fill me without the power of darkness.
I know now. The Kingdom Hearts is light.
Oh, fuck.
Supreme darkness.
And then it is. And then it wasn't. I know now. So I guess the only thing is that this isn't actually Kingdom Hearts. This is the door to darkness. The realm of darkness, and Kingdom Hearts is elsewhere. I guess Kingdom Hearts is the heart shape.
You're right. Oh my darkness.
Man, I don't know. They seem to like flip flop between Kingdom Hearts being over a place or being, I guess, like the equivalent of the Matrix and Transformers or Beast Wars.
I'm sure we'll never see him again.
Sure, we won't see him again and again and again and again and again.
I can't look at this scene anymore of Donald looking into the door without looking at thinking the dumb edit I made of the fucking smiling Fred's guy popping out and going, I was just wondering if you would like to hang out with me. I can't unsee my own stupid edit.
Come on, Sora. Together we could do it. Okay.
Well,
I definitely want to do 2 at some point, but what I might do with 2 versus this game is when we get into late game, do like stuff off screen. Because I kind of regret not doing that with this game, because it would have made things much smoother in the final stretch of the game.
It's hopeless.
It's okay, Riku's here, and so is he! So is me!
Well, so is the king's back, because he's not actually going to do anything.
I'm the true seeker of darkness, Sora! Me! Mickey Mouse!
Because we could only afford to have him, you know.
They were only allowed to use him here.
There will always be a door to the light. Sora, you can trust King Mickey.
Honestly, I feel like Minimal Mickey is better Mickey.
I mean, I think Kingdom Hearts 2 is the appropriate amount of
4, 5, 6. That was all the time they were allowed to actually show his face in the game. 6 seconds.
Yeah. I actually think 2 is the appropriate amount of Mickey. He's like, he's there. He can even sometimes be playable, but he's not just doing nothing.
Oh yeah, but I don't remember him being like a pain. I'm just saying, Minimal Mickey's best Mickey.
I even remember like how it wasn't until Zaldin, which is second half of the game when you're revisiting all the levels, that I realized that Mickey could actually show up and be a playable character.
He's,
That's most people, because he's the first boss that's actually, like, kind of hard, and you're probably going to lose to him.
Yeah, Zoldan is a bit of a bitch, isn't he?
I actually never got to play as Mickey in the original. I never had that. I knew it was a thing, and I never had it happen.
Damn. Well, I don't know how you got past Zoldan without dying, but fair enough.
I don't know. Probably if I stream it, I won't do that well.
Well, yeah, Zoldan is a bit of a prick.
Time for their final mix exclusive flashback that wasn't in the original.
See, we had to see exclusive content. See. Aren't you happy now, Sabo?
Yes.
We did technically see exclusive content in that we saw the Heartless recolors.
Oh yes, that too.
True.
Didn't do anything else, I just recolored them.
You silly.
Bye, Sora. I'm going to Irrelevant Land.
This is the last time I get to have a personality. Bye.
I mean, she'd have to show up on screen to have a personality.
Yeah, he's got you there.
Yeah, but she shows up in screen more in, like, 3 than she does in this game, and yet somehow...
That's because all of her appearances in 3 is basically her just talking to Axel, so Axel can have personality.
Well, she basically almost talks like an alien.
I'd say she actually does have a pretty defined personality in her scenes in 2. It's just, she doesn't act, it's just, you keep thinking it's going to lead to something, and it just doesn't.
True.
Because then they're like, oh yeah, here, have a Keyblade, Curry. You're like, wait, what? Is this going to be a thing? No.
Not really. Not until you bully Nomura for a DLC.
I mean, Axel did get to fight Xemnas badly.
Did you remember it?
I will kill you, Axel. Nobody kills Axel. Did you remember it? Damn it, why do I have to be the comic relief character?
Rip Axel. He died as he lived, looking an awful lot like Reno.
It's okay, Lee's here.
No, but he's Axel.
He is Lee. He's like, just call me Axel.
That's the joke.
I forget what Syax was even called. Isa?
Yeah, something like that.
Kind of funny, because Syax is just a cunt.
Why did you betray everyone and try to destroy the world? I want the friends. Understandable.
Light, darkness, light, darkness. Why not light? I like darkness. Okay. Man, I love all those characters got all of those cutscenes and all of those build-ups to have their fights completely stolen from them because Sora had to do everything.
Because Sora is the only playable character.
When we need to have 7 lights versus 13 darknesses, like, don't you mean 1 light versus all of them? Well, yes, we're not going to admit that. Love that we had to spend an entire game of waking these assholes up so they could do fucking nothing. Oh, yeah, I guess Seth Dan's not got to that part yet, but he will.
Yeah, I have not touched it since, hi, Afro. I haven't touched it since beating Frozen World, because I've been addicted to Neo. Game's really fun.
You're missing out on Monsters Inc. World.
I mean, it's not like I'm not going to play it. It's just I'm really addicted to Neo too. It's really fun.
Finally, it had Samurai Pizza Cats.
Samurai Pizza Cats for Kingdom Hearts 4.
Sure, why not? I'd rather that than actually include Star Wars.
Who do you call when you want some pepperoni? They had to get the cast back that are still alive and, of course, give them a bottle of liquor and just let them talk.
Yeah, pretty much.
Hey, if it works.
Yeah, it's so good. I mean, it's in 2 I've been playing. I can't remember if I said 2 or not. It's... really fun. This is like the first Souls-like that I like really got like attached to.
Yeah, that's something I should be looking forward to. Elden Ring DLC.
I learned that one of the yokai forms, you can cancel out of animations using its burst counter. So you can like cancel out, dash, go into another animation, cancel out.
Neat.
You can also apparently use it to go to bypass traps and obstacles in the actual stages. So, like, when boulders drop on you, you can just be like, I'm just gonna pretend you don't exist and dash through you. Bye. I don't care.
I decided I'm not gonna take that damage.
I decided no. Is that fire on the ground impeding my progress? What if I just said no? Did you consider that?
Nope.
I just dabbed the fire.
But, again, I still like how you can find, like, weird ways to bypass some of the optional yokai, like, doing it like a gesture for the Tanuki, and then they're just like, I like you, have this, have the things, and rather than me trying to kill you. Or doing the appropriate gestures for the fake walls, and just, like, let you through, rather than having to fight them.
In D&D last week, one of the party members wound up getting bounced high in the air by some magic bullshit. And I did try to convince him to do the 8-bit fear to block the ground maneuver. Sadly, he didn't do it, so he just wound up getting hurt.
Honestly, that's his fault.
Well, yeah, why didn't you block the ground?
Block it.
There's like one of my two. There's like one of my three favorite 8-bit theatred gags I always go back to. So I have a fighter going, yeah, so I realised it's the ground that causes the problem, so I just block the ground. Or it's the one where fighter starts deciding people should be in teams, and he's on every team, but also he's on his own team with three other fighters called the Fighting Fighters. And then, you know, the final one. And then, you know, the other joke is, the final joke of the shut of the comic. Oh, where it's like four white mages beat chaos.
Good.
I was, because they spent like, guy spent like fucking a decade setting up that joke.
Four white mages, it'll never work.
Yeah, literally the first issue is four white mages beating chaos, it'll never happen. And then like 10 years later on this final issue,
four white mages beat chaos?
Yeah.
You know what though? I respect the commitment to that bit.
Yeah.
Like, he didn't stray from that bit. He's like, no, I'm doing this bit. Are you sure? Yes. Are you sure? Yes. Are you sure? I'm doing it right now.
I will spend 10 years of my life just to do this one bit. I respect that.
Well, horrible people that need to be taken out for the good of society. Except Fighter. Yay. He's a casualty. No.
God.
Poor Fighter. Reminds me of the bit in Futurama with Robot Santa, where it's like, you're all naughty, naughty, except you, Zoidberg, here.
Hurrah! I love how he, like, bounces away on the pogo stick.
I think my other favorite.
Because I was looking at something someone sent me. I just looked back over. I like the little, like, goodbye thing for the Princesses of Light, where they all, like, giving you little curtsies and shit.
Yeah. Everyone gets to have a nice sort of. Everyone gets a nice happy ending, except Sora.
Except Sora.
Get used to this trend.
Yeah. Except Sora.
But, like, yeah, everyone else gets to go back home. The, you know, the world, the threat's over. Everybody's like, hey, look, the Far Fantasy crew are back in Hollow Bastion. They can start putting that back. You know, Belle gets to meet with her horrible, abusive boyfriend again. Yeah, everyone else having a great time. Except Sora, he's now stuck in the middle of buttfuck nowhere with Donald and Goofy. And just vaguely hoping that maybe if we chase this dog, we can find our way back home or find our friends.
Kind of works.
Yeah, I guess. Pluto does lead them to Castle Oblivion, so...
Only Zane. The only time is answer.
Yeah. Well... I remember who voices him in everything else. Is it Doug Erholt?
I forget.
And this is VA sticks around.
James Woods at the very bottom.
I mean, he's the one who—he's probably the most surprising because he's an actual actor.
Yeah, he's like, I'll be Katie's, Kingdom Hearts. Sure, I don't care.
I mean, I know Tom Hanks probably...
He even played the game.
damn. But yeah, I mean, I know Tom Hanks would have voiced Woody in 3 if he had could, but you know. Tom Hanks, you have to give him like $1 billion to get him to do anything.
Yeah, he's like, my brother will handle it.
Close enough.
Yeah, unfortunately, when I was playing it, one of the things I noticed is that unfortunately, his brother and also who they got for like Buzz just aren't really good voice actors. They were just they were given like really wooden performances.
They should have got Patrick Warburton for Buzz.
I was gonna say, yeah, they should have Patrick Warburton for Buzz. He played him in the cartoon show. He didn't really sound like Tim Allen, but
yeah,
close enough.
Right. He did his job. I mean, they did like a movie/pilot for that, which is like 3 episodes in one. That cartoon, Sabo.
I mean, Disney did that a lot.
Yeah, but you know, there's 2 versions of that pilot movie.
Really?
Yeah, there's one where Tim Allen voices it, and one where Patrick Warburton voices it.
I didn't know that. Tim Allen was too expensive for the show.
I think so. I think they had the budget to get him for the movie, or they had the budget to get him to record, to re-record the dialogue for the movie, because they gave it. It was when they had like the studio that did all the direct-to-video stuff. They were handling it, and then yeah, Patrick Warburton was the actual voice throughout the rest of the show. And I'm pretty sure there's 2 cut. There's 2 dubs of that movie, different Buzz voices.
I was going to say, I don't think I've ever seen the cut with Tim Allen.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, maybe it's on Disney Plus, I don't know. I don't think they allow Buzz Lightyear Star Command on Disney Plus, because I think the guy who made Lightyear hates it.
Yeah, pretty much.
But he also hates Toy Story, so I don't fucking know.
Yeah, well, I mean, yeah, but there's no way in hell they couldn't get Toy Story on there. I don't think the guy who made Lightyear has a lot of pull anymore.
Yeah, not after it lost to fucking Minions.
However, unfortunately, all they're going to do now is probably, like, Toy Story sequels and shit, because they're like, we don't want to do anything that's, quote-quote risky anymore. Hey, Pluto. So I think Pixar is now just going to make sequels.
Probably.
Rest in peace, Pixar.
I mean, they're making Inside Out 2, and that's coming out to mixed reviews, so...
Yeah.
But I mean, Pixar's been on the downward spiral for quite a while, so...
Where they, like, occasionally... Where now it's more like they occasionally accidentally make something, like, new that's fun, and then back to, we're gonna make another Toy Story sequel. Or we're gonna make this sequel, or this just, thing.
Or stuff that nobody cares about. Two days later, saw his balls drop, and he winds up stuck playing card games. Sorry, Marluxia, you activated my trap card. Marluxia on his fucking rose dragon form. Draw your last pathetic card, Sora.
It's worth noting, this was all thrown together at the last minute, and originally Sora was just going to go home with Kairi, and that would be the end.
And then they were like, hey, maybe we might get a sequel out of this.
Yeah, and then they're like, maybe we'll be doing... It's like, originally Maleficent was going to be the final boss, and Ansem wasn't going to be in it at all.
Yeah. And they're like, well, I guess we need an original villain.
I think it would have been cool. I honestly still say ending with Kingdom Hearts 2 is perfectly fine.
I mean, it is a cap off to things, but...
But that's yeah, but it! The credits are over. I like the little illustration at the end with them all just kind of sitting and chilling.
Yeah.
And you know
you have to do several things to get different illustrations at the end.
See, I didn't know that.
That's the set. Yeah, in every game it's
including several that are Final Mix exclusive.
Yeah.
That's nice.
Like bonus bosses and shit.
If I do that, it'll probably be when I eventually get the Steam version. Because I do want to get the Steam version of these, so I have them on the computer. Because that's the means mods. And also, I tend to play things more on PC versus console. I literally turned this console on just to play these games. Like, it was like collecting dust, and I hooked it back up just for this.
console is it?
PS4.
PS4.
Yeah. I rarely do anything on console anymore. But, yeah, that's it. That's it for the stream, because I do, need to, I do need to leave in a couple of minutes on my own to start cooking anyway. Thank you for coming by. Next week, maybe Bloodstained, unless I change my mind, because I do that. I do want to do 2 at some point, but I don't think I want to do it right away. So I'll probably do a game, and then do 2. Unless I also change my mind at that point, too. Or maybe I'll change my mind and I do 2 next week. Who knows? I don't. I think it's time to leave.
Time to leave.